Well, the wait is over. It's part two of the top 10 states for taxes, and it's right here. When moving states, one thing you have to consider before deciding where you're going to make your new home is, what is the tax situation like? But because the internet is a vast and chaotic place, we have gathered it up for you, the top 10 best states for taxes, so you can make your best decision and research a little easier. Stay with us till the end because there's big surprises coming your way. And be sure you saw part one, and if you haven't already, well, you might want to back up and check it out. There's some hidden gems there. Are you ready? Let's go. Number one on the list is Nevada. If you've got a dream of moving to the Silver State, this listing will make you start packing up and looking for houses on your way. Why? Because Nevada has no income tax. Take a look at our stats. The state income tax range, none. The average combined state and local sales tax, 8.23%. And the median property tax rate is $533 per $100,000 of assessed home value. That's pretty good, eh? If you're looking for a catch, this time we're happy to tell you there is none. Nevada is blessed not only by having no income tax, but the others are going to treat you well too. The property tax rates are the fourth lowest in the country. The only thing that's a bit of an ouchie is that sales tax rate at 6.85%. And that's to say, not really low. Yeah, but, you know, you win some, you lose some. And this is Vegas. Number two, Tennessee. Well, if you want to shop till you drop and you like to do it often, Tennessee's not the best state because their sales tax has a 7% plus 2.75 on top of that. And you're looking at that on anything from $1,600 to $3,200 of single items. But on the other hand, though, if you're interested in not having high income and property tax, the volunteer state may be just where you want to go. Look at these stats. The state income tax range, 1%, but that's only on interest and dividends. The average combined state and local sales tax rate is 9.55%, and that varies. Median property tax rate is $636 per $100,000 of assessed home value. Technically, there's no broad-based income tax in Tennessee. Only interest and dividends are subject to their limited income tax. As for the property tax, it's below the national average, so buy to your heart's content, as long as we're talking about houses and not designer bags. Number three, it's Washington. The Evergreen State gives us all the honey we need to lure us in, but then it kind of takes it back. What do we mean by this weird metaphor? Well, there's no income tax in Washington. Whoop, whoop. But wait, that doesn't mean it's tax-friendly as a state. The property taxes are, let's say, kind of normal, but the sales tax, not good. It has a base rate of 6.5 plus at 9.23, the Tax Foundation's average combined state and local sales tax rate in Washington. It's the fourth highest in the country. But let's get the other stats. State income tax range, none. Average combined state and local sales tax rate, 9.23%. And the median property tax rate, $929 per $100,000 of assessed home value. Now, it's really up to you. If you want to live there, make sure you're not a shopaholic and you don't buy a villa. Keep your money because you'll have no income tax. Perfect for the little Scrooges everywhere. Number four, it's North Dakota. The Peace Garden State has an income tax that's so tiny it's hard to even consider it as a tax. And we love it for that. Let's take a look at those stats. State income tax range, 1.1% on taxable income up to $40,125 for single filers and $67,050 for joint filers. Then 2.9% if you're over $440,600. Who makes that kind of money? Anyway, average combined state and local sales tax rate, 6.96%, and the median property tax rate, $986 per $100,000 of assessed home value. Right? Right? I mean, this is definitely one of the lower taxes in any state, especially if we're talking about middle-class families. And because, come on, you do love a little bit of shopping here and there, and you must know North Dakota's not going to judge you for it. The sales tax is actually 5%, which is average, if not pretty low. Plus, according to the Tax Foundation, the average combined state and local sales tax rate is 6.96%, which is, again, average going on low. As for property taxes, you'll find that North Dakota is slightly above the national property tax average, but surely we can forgive that when comparing to other states. All right, number five, Wyoming. We've left the best for last, and the Equality State is the best state for those who want a balance and actual low taxes, and we mean on all fronts. Let's start with those sweet stats. State income tax range, none. Average combined state and local sales tax rate, 5.33%, and the median property tax rate, right down there too, $575 per 100,000 of assessed home value. I mean, where are my bags? I am packing up right now. Apart from the fact that the income tax is zero and a hero, sorry, can't stop with the bad puns when I'm excited, excuse me, Wyoming has low sales tax and low property tax. This is the state you were looking for. Your ears don't deceive you. Want proof? The sales tax is 4% and the property tax is a tenth lowest in the country. Let's hear it for Wyoming. Now's time for that whoop whoop. Plus, you know, Yellowstone's there, so you really don't have any excuses. So pack your bags, and I'll meet you there. Well, there you have it for today. These were the top 10 best states for taxes, part 2. And if you haven't watched part 1 yet, well, jump right back to the channel and find that video, because while you're there, you'll want to check out the other videos too and hit the subscribe button like there's no tomorrow. Now it's time to hear from you. Which of the 5 states in this video do you like the most and why? Let us know in the comments, and we'll see you next time.